Hello everyone, Boomer again with another video where I try to break down relatively complicated topics in an easy to understand way. Today we'll be discussing methods and strategies for traveling out of the Nether and back to the overworld, in a manner that increases your chances of quickly finding the stronghold. While the technique I'm about to discuss is used by speedrunners, any Minecraft enthusiast can benefit from this information. Let's jump right into it. I'll be reviewing two methods, one referred to as blind travel and the other referred to as educated travel. Blind travel is a method of returning from the Nether to the overworld where, rather than using the same portal you did to enter the Nether, you build a second portal and blindly travel to a completely different location in hopes of returning to the overworld closer to a stronghold than traveling through the original portal would have accomplished. Educated travel, in its most basic form, involves leaving the Nether using the same portal you did to enter, checking the direction of the closest stronghold, returning to the Nether, then traveling in that direction for a set amount of blocks, then building a second portal, thus returning to the overworld in a location that's essentially an educated guess. Finally, in the right situation, we can combine the two methods and give us an even greater chance of quickly finding a stronghold. Let's take a look at a basic example of blind travel. So here I am, battling blazes, and I get my 7th blaze rod. Before leaving the fortress, I check my coordinates and figure out the best way to travel to build my second portal. In this situation, I've decided to build my portal where X equals 220 and Z equals 0. We'll discuss why in a bit. In this particular scenario, it's relatively easy for me to travel to the exact location I'm targeting. Obviously, that won't always be the case. Since I have a few extra ender pearls, I decide to use one to speed things up. Not that you need to be as precise as I am here, but as you can see, I'm looking for the specific block where X equals 220 and Z equals 0. Of course, it wouldn't be Minecraft if I didn't have a giant flying marshmallow shooting fireballs at me. It's important to note that this technique requires obsidian, which is typically obtained by routing bastions. If you're not using bastion strategies and don't have other means of creating a second portal in the Nether, you won't be able to blind travel. So, I not so quickly build my portal, light it, and head back to the overworld. I'll speed this up a bit, but as you can see, I craft my Eyes of Ender, check the direction, and head off. I probably should have used triangulation to get an idea of my current distance to the stronghold. But since I was in an ocean, which makes accurate triangulation a little more difficult, and there's a chance the stronghold is ocean exposed, and I'm not trying to break the world record, I just decided to head in the direction indicated by my first throw. After less than a minute of travel, I see the light from the portal room. The first step in understanding both blind travel and educated travel is to understand where strongholds spawn. As shown here, strongholds spawn in the overworld in concentric rings expanding out from 0-0. The size or width of each ring is defined by the radius, measured in blocks, corresponding to the beginning and end of each ring. Also shown here, each ring will have a different number of strongholds. For example, the first ring has 3, the second ring has 6, the third ring has 10, and so on. The anchor point of each stronghold may occur anywhere within the inner and outer limits of each ring. Perhaps the most important takeaway from this information is that we can use simple math to calculate the corresponding rings in the Nether. By knowing where these rings exist in the Nether, we can be more deliberate about where we spawn back in the overworld. For the purposes of this video, I'll be focusing primarily on the first ring as it's the most commonly used during speedruns. However, the same principles apply for other rings. Let's move over to the Nether. The Nether can be broken down into a grid as shown here. Each square of the grid is 432 blocks by 432 blocks as defined by X and Z, and are referred to as regions. Only one structure, i.e. a bastion or a fortress, can spawn in a given region. Of course, neither can spawn as well, and sometimes structures spill over to an adjacent region. The regions we'll be focusing on are the four quadrants located around 0-0. When speedrunning, These are the areas in the Nether we're hoping to find structures, so we minimize our travel time and the risks associated with hanging out in the Nether for too long. There are certainly reasons why you'd travel outside these quadrants, but we'll save that for another day. As mentioned previously, we can divide the number of blocks associated with each stronghold ring by 8 and determine the corresponding ring in the Nether. Here, we see the first ring shows up between 160 blocks and 352 blocks, which happens to fall right in the middle of the four quadrants around 00. So now we have a pretty good idea where to build our portal to exit the Nether and give us a decent shot at landing near a stronghold. Conceptually, this sounds simple. But since we're dealing with circles and Minecraft is based on blocks and squares, we'll need to dig a bit deeper. One other important thing to point out is that strongholds will be evenly spaced radially around the ring. In the case of the first ring, each stronghold will be 120 degrees apart, with their anchor points landing somewhere between the minimum and maximum numbers associated with the ring. Next, some really smart people have done extensive testing to find out this ring within the ring, where building your portal will have the best chance of spawning you back into the overworld near a stronghold. I'll leave a link to T-Wag's video in the description. T-Wag also credits SharpyMan20 with assisting in the process. The purple ring you see here represents a distance of 216 blocks from 00, and its justification is thoroughly discussed in T-Wag's video. We'll take a closer look at how to use this in just a minute. For reference, here's the ring in the Nether associated with the second stronghold ring. Notice the second ring has 6 strongholds spaced out 60 degrees apart. As you can see, the second ring comes in contact with each of the 4 quadrants surrounding 00 and may be a viable option in some situations. Alright, so now that we understand stronghold rings, let's talk about where, within the ring, we should build our portal for the best chance of returning to the overworld near a stronghold. Obviously, this technique does not guarantee anything, but over the long run, you should find yourself in a better location than picking a random spot within the ring, and certainly better than just randomly blinding back to the overworld anywhere you feel like. What we're looking at here is a chart created by K4 and SharpyMan20 that simplifies the concept of the ideal blind location. In preparation for this video, I also watched a video by K4, which I'll link to in my description. There you'll find a link to this image and others showing ideal blind locations for the second and third rings. Before we go any further, I'd like to point out that using calculators during a speedrun is not allowed. However, to my knowledge, it's okay to have something like this printed out and available for reference. That being said, K4 and SharpyMan20 did a really good job of simplifying this to a point where memorization shouldn't be too difficult. The way you use this is fairly straightforward. You'll want to build your portal as close to these coordinates as possible. Because we're dealing with a circle, once you have memorized these 6 coordinate sets, you may swap the values for X and Z, as well as switch them between positive and negative values based on your current location. For example, blinding at negative 210, negative 50 would also land you somewhere within the first ring in an area with a higher statistical chance of being near a stronghold. In my earlier example, I chose to blind at 220-0, which spawned me back in the overworld 395 blocks away from the nearest stronghold. As I mentioned earlier, an alternative to blind travel is educated travel. The most basic way to use educated travel is to return to the portal you use to enter the Nether. Once you're back in the overworld, you simply throw an Eye of Ender, make note of the angle of travel, then go back into the Nether and travel to the ideal coordinate located at that angle. As you can see here, the eye traveled in the direction of 132.6 degrees. Let's reference the chart to determine the ideal coordinate to build our next portal. We'll also want to consider that the Eye of Ender points us to the closest stronghold, indicating it's probably closer to the inside of the ring than the outside. Because I've done this many times, I know that any angle between 90 and 180 degrees will point towards the negative-negative quadrant. And I also know that an angle of 132.6 degrees is essentially halfway between 90 and 180. Therefore, I know I should be shooting for about negative 155, negative 155, which is what I'm doing here. After I get reasonably close to my targeted location, I would build a portal and travel back to the overworld, and hopefully wind up close to the stronghold. Checking the distance reveals that we were able to get within 232 blocks of the stronghold, which is outstanding. The last technique I'd like to show you is a combination between blind travel and educated travel. The only way you can pull this off is if you somehow obtained enough obsidian from piglin trades or other methods that you're able to build two separate portals out of the Nether. I built my blind travel portal at roughly 75-200, which is in line with the chart we looked at just a minute ago. The first thing to do after exiting the Nether is to use a triangulation method to determine if we should consider educated travel or if we're already close enough to the stronghold. In case you're not familiar with triangulation, I made a video that should help you understand what I'm doing here. I can't give you an exact distance where it makes sense to use the Nether to expedite your travel, as it depends on the Nether's terrain, your skills, and the resources you have in your inventory. In this example, I've calculated that I'm at least 1,000 blocks from the stronghold, and traveling through the Nether is doable. Having said that, I'll fast forward through some of this and skip the part where I nearly died to hoglins. Although I didn't check, it's entirely possible it would have been faster for me to travel in the overworld since I ended up spending some time towered up avoiding my impending doom. I made my final portal close to 190-100, which is one of the options shown on our chart. After exiting the Nether, I performed an additional triangulation, which revealed I was extremely close to the stronghold. In fact, I was less than 100 blocks away. Well, that's all I have for this video. I hope you enjoyed this and also hope it helps improve your game in some way. I have lots of ideas planned for the future and look forward to putting out more content. Until next time, bye!